The only thing I remember what I thought is this real?
Like, I couldn't believe this was happening. You know, this guy's trying to rob me in broad daylight.
Everything was fine until he raised that gun.
And he said, give me all your money. And he showed me he had a gun.
These people are survivors, everyday Americans who live to tell their stories because they were armed with a crucial life-saving freedom, the right to carry a firearm.
The only thing that saved him was that he did have his gun and he shot the bad guy first.
It was 10:40 p.m., a quiet Sunday night. Habib was working at his family's convenience store in Toledo, Ohio, when a man put a 12-pack of beer on the counter.
Before I could say, may I see your ID, please, or anything, he pulled out the gun, said, give me the money.
Habib had rehearsed this scenario dozens of times with his dad, but this time, it was real. Habib was staring down the barrel of the robber's gun.
He began to raise it, and that's when I pulled mine.
Bullet holes left behind, a reminder of a choice Habib never thought he'd be forced to make.
You don't know unless you're put in that situation what you would do.
And a robber who was stopped before he got killed or killed someone else.
How many more store clerks would have gone through what I went through? How many bank tellers? How many children? Criminals don't care.
But Habib found out plenty of law-abiding people do.
I think the robber got exactly what he had coming to him.
This is a letter from an attorney down in Dallas, Texas. It says, Dear Mr. Howard, I salute your courage and conviction in the way you handled yourself and your licensed weapon in the unfortunate incident of the robbery.
Yes, I'm definitely determined not to become a victim.
Felicia Moss was making a quick stop at home, talking on the phone with her husband, when all of a sudden, she's attacked from behind.
What? I heard my wife just screaming and screaming.
But Felicia tries to stay calm, walks to the back of her car, and starts searching through her purse for money.
If I take out my wallet, I show him I don't have any money. And I said, but wait a minute.
Felicia was stalling for time, knowing she also had a handgun inside her purse.
When I pulled out my gun, you could see it in his face. He was shocked. That's why he tried to take it from me.
But Felicia wouldn't let go, and the suspect took off running.
Yeah, the police said that I did a great job. They were very proud of me.
What the guy didn't know, he didn't know that my wife is a pit bull in a skirt.
Survivors who are foot soldiers in a right to carry revolution.
Uh-huh. There you go, you did it.
Where citizens are determined not to be left defenseless, and criminals operate at their own risk.
And they never know who's going to have a gun and be able to defend themselves or not.
If the bad guy thinks everybody's armed, the bad guy's not gonna risk his life for.
Fortunately for Habib, Ohio's concealed carry law had just gone into effect.
I thank God every day that the NRA and everybody did their part to get this law passed, because I honestly don't think I would be here.
A life-saving right. A revolution that began back in Florida when a grandmother named Marion Hammer took on a tireless task to restore right to carry.
People kept saying, give it up, it's not going to happen, you're not going to be able to pass it.
Political cartoonists couldn't draw their sketches fast enough, and headlines threatened that Florida would turn into the OK Corral or the Wild Wild West.
Emotional and political eyewash, I like to call it.
It took 7 years, but Marion's grassroots effort paid off. In 1987, Florida passed the nation's first shall-issue right-to-carry law.
You can't imagine what it feels like to see the groundswell that we saw.
It's been just a brush fire going from state to state.
From Virginia to Arizona, from North Carolina to Texas. In all, 38 states now have right to carry, and more than 2 million Americans have gotten their permits. Law-abiding gun owners who have proven the critics and gloom and doom media wrong.
It didn't happen in Florida, it didn't happen in Texas, it didn't happen in other states. It's a bunch of baloney. Baloney.
The reason? Firearms training classes like this, and the extensive background checks required of anyone who wants to get a license to carry. As a husband, a father, and a police captain, Rich Stenick fought hard to get the law passed in Minnesota.
But I didn't see anything to fear by it. In fact, I thought it was just the opposite. As a police officer, and it was ingrained in me from day one that, look, you know, Officer Stenick, you cannot be everywhere all the time. People have to take responsibility for their own safety.
The state of Wisconsin will not allow me the choice of how to protect myself.
You would think that what happened to Teresa Sweet wife and mother of three, would give her every right to carry a firearm.
I had been raped repeatedly for over 6 hours. I'd been beaten up by three guys.
And even though her attackers have never been caught, Teresa's plea to Wisconsin lawmakers has still gone unanswered.
How can you people not understand that we need to protect ourselves?
They have not been a victim.
In Kansas, this victim is so afraid that her attacker will return, she asked us to conceal her identity.
I was raped in my own home with my daughters in the next room. 911 would not have helped me. You need something to protect yourself right then.
Still, just as in Wisconsin, Kansas law won't allow her to carry a firearm.
What really frustrated me was it did pass, and then the governor vetoed it. But she has this patronizing feeling that they know what's best for us, and they don't. What's best for us is to be able to protect ourselves.
And Kansas lawmaker Candy Ruff says she won't quit until that happens. Because now that neighboring Missouri has right to carry on the books, you can bet where the criminals are headed.
They're going to head straight across the line. That should give you a moment's pause, those that think this isn't a good idea.
Personal protection, not politics. And law enforcement has the numbers to prove it's working.
Crime rates go down. Violent crime rates go down.
In fact, according to the FBI, in 2003, this nation's violent crime rate declined for the 12th straight year to a 27-year low. John Long of Shreveport, Louisiana, puts another human face on the nationwide success of right-to-carry laws. Not too long ago, a car pulled up in front of his shop and three men got out.
One comes to the back of the trunk, he opens the trunk, reaches in, pulls out a revolver and sticks it in his belt and covers it up with his shirt. I walk up to all three of them, I had my hand on the gun, ready to go. And they all three look at each other like, we just look and we go somewhere else.
One crime averted, but the criminals just drove off in search of another victim.
I was right behind that counter right there.
A couple of miles away, Bill Stroud was doing paperwork at his family's hardware store when one of the three men burst through the door, yelling.
He's got a bandana over his face and he's got a pistol pointing right at me, cocked. And he is telling me, give me all your money, don't move, I'm fixing to shoot, I'm fixing to kill you.
Yep. I look up and...
But I did know that I had a gun.
Suddenly, a noise in the back of the store caught the robber's attention, and Bill quickly reached for his firearm.
I had no intentions in that day to ever take a life and wouldn't ever want to have to do that. But I didn't have a choice.
As it turns out, the man Bill Stroud shot was a dangerous fugitive, wanted for attempted murder and several armed robberies.
And I don't understand how they say if they get rid of the guns, if they make it illegal, that criminals will not have guns. This guy, it was illegal for this guy to have a gun, yet he found one.
Criminals who beat the system and innocent law-abiding citizens who are determined to beat the odds with the freedom they know is rightfully theirs.
And it's about individual rights. It's about personal rights.
You know, the neat thing about this is that it is a grassroots movement.
We see people ranging from doctors, lawyers, factory workers, all walks of life.
I'm living proof that the law works.
This is your right. This is not the politicians to give and take away.
But the fight is far from over.
It's not over, and it won't be over until every single state has right to carry.
And to those states that still deny Americans this right, a message to lawmakers from those whose lives hang in the balance.
Stop playing Russian roulette with other people's lives.
Every time that a woman is raped, every time a person is murdered, those people that voted against the concealed carry ought to think, could this have been prevented?
For the lawmakers who don't want to do this, I say to the citizens of that state, vote that individual out of office. We have enough victims. Let's stop it. It needs to stop now.